I wrote a book and published it in 2001 called Vermeer's Camera. The book was about the idea that the great Dutch painter used the camera obscura, which is a predecessor of the photographic camera, and it's just a lens and you project an image. It was quite an old idea, lots of people have suggested that, but I had some new arguments. You can take paintings that are of architectural scenes, of interiors like Vermeer's, and you can work the perspective backwards. You can go from the two-dimensional image to the three-dimensional scene, and you can reconstruct the architecture. And Vermeer, it's clear, painted quite a number of pictures, maybe as many as 8 or 10, in one room, his studio in Delft. And in each case, you can determine his viewpoint, and you can see the extent of what is visible in the picture, which is a pyramid lying on its side, whose point is at the viewpoint. If you carry the lines of this pyramid back through the viewpoint to meet the back wall, you describe a rectangle in each case. And in at least 6 cases, that rectangle is the exact size of Vermeer's painting. It would be very difficult to see how that could arise, other than him having a lens, projecting images, and they're the same size as the pictures because he's traced them. And that's the essence of my argument.
Sometimes when I'm trying to get to sleep, all I can think about is trying to paint a Vermeer, who some consider the greatest painter of all time. At the face of it, that seems almost impossible, because I'm not a painter.
A man called Tim Jennison, who's an engineer, his daughter gave him a copy of my book for Christmas, and he got very interested. And he thought that he could take the argument a bit further. I left 2 questions unresolved at the book, in the end of the book. I had some ideas, but one of them was that if you project an image onto a wall or a screen, as you would with a simple camera obscura, then it's mirrored. How could you then, it's clear that the paintings themselves are not mirror images, so how could you reverse that? That's not too complicated. The other problem was much more difficult. If you're, the cameras that they were using in the 17th century, some of them were little boxes like modern photographic cameras, but mostly they were booths, they were tents or cubicles that were inside, and you're in the darkness or semi-darkness. And how could you paint? How could you, could draw, you could trace an image, but how could you see the colours of your paints and get the hues right? One reason that people think that Vermeer used the camera obscura or some kind of optical aid is that his paintings do look photographic. And I think what we mean when we say photographic is that the tones are absolutely true. That's what we see that resembles photographs. So how could you do that inside camera? And as I say, Jennison had this idea that you could... he had an idea for a device which would allow you to paint in the semi-darkness and get the tones right. And so he decided to paint a Vermeer, although he'd never painted in his life.
So you're going to construct a replica of the exact room where Vermeer painted?
That's right.
The harpsichord, the Spanish chair, the viola da gamba, the rug.
The wind's trying to blow my shape.
Well, this certainly is not easy.
Okay, well, this is Tim Jennison's device, or at least part of his setup. It's just a little flat mirror on a stick, as you see. And the way it works is that you project a camera image onto a wall, and you put your canvas flat in front of that image on the wall. And you put this, you have this mirror, and you look down on it. And in the mirror, you see part of the optical image. And as you look past the edge of the mirror, you can see part of your canvas. And then you apply paint just by the edge of the mirror. And if the hue and tone of the paint match what you see in the mirror, then you've got a match with the optical image. In fact, at that point, you can't see the edge of the mirror. And that's the essence of how it's done. That's how the image is transcribed. And the fact that it's a mirror means that it reverses the optical image, so you're back with a correct way round picture. And this also solves the problem of working in low light, because everything's in low light. The image is in low light, your canvas is in low light, but if you're matching, then it doesn't matter. This device that Tim Jennison uses, it's simple, it's certainly within the scope of 17th century technology, and it works. There's no doubt that you can produce, as an amateur, you can produce Vermeer-like photographic effects by transcribing the optical image. But the question that remains is, did Vermeer use this method? We know very little about Vermeer, we know very little about his life, nobody writes about his methods, he didn't write about his methods. He had, so far as we know, no pupils. So the only places you can really look are in the paintings themselves. And then could you find mentions in the contemporary literature? And Jensen and I have looked very hard in books on painting techniques, such as they are, of the period, and there's nothing similar. His device is a bit like a sort of short-distance telescope. It's a bit like a reflecting telescope, a telescope with a mirror in it, but reflecting telescopes weren't built until the 18th century.